हेलो गाइस, गुड मॉर्निंग. गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल. दिस इज हनुमान नायक एंड वेलकम टू अवर चैनल स्मार्ट स्टडी. सो इन दिस क्लास आई गोना एक्सप्लेन यू दैट द चैप्टर नंबर 2 फिफ्थ स्टैंडर्ड ओलंपियाड मैथमेटिक्स. यस, नाउ सी दैट आवर चैप्टर नंबर 2 इज फोर ऑपरेशंस. व्हाट आर द फोर ऑपरेशंस आर दोज? वन इज एडिशन एंड सेकेंड वन इज सब्ट्रैक्शन, मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड डिविजन्स. Okay, and we have to learn, we know some minimum basic knowledge about these four, and in this chapter we're gonna learn that to quicker operations, do the calculation, whatever you did done in fourth standard compared to that standard in this class, you have to learn that somewhat quick. If you are learning same methodology what we applied in the fourth or third standard, if you apply same methodology in the fifth standard, then what is the use of that? There is no use, na. So in this chapter we have to learn that some few important and simplest form of the how to do the addition, how to do the subtraction, multiplication and division, and so on. So, and these are the, we have to start from the beginning to ending. We have to start from beginning to ending. That may be that 1 digit, 2 digit, 3 digit, 4 digit, 5 digit, and so on, large numbers also. That is our point number 2. And point number 3, the relation between addition and subtraction, relation between multiplication and division, and division rules. So the division rules means what? 2 table division rule, 3 table division rule, and so on up to so we can see all these things. So we already completed that how to do the addition, how to do the subtraction, and how to do the multiplication. So we are, did you completed the multiplication? No. Up to what? How much you are completed? Subtraction we are completed. Now in this next topic is what rules of multiplications and division. So before going to the rules of multiplication and division, I have to tell few things. That is, if you are multiplication into 2 digit, if your multiplication 2 digit into 2 digit, how to solve the 2 digit into 2 digit multiplication? For example, here the multiplication are divided in some different categories. The in that first category is, for example, here 11 into 23 is the number. If in the my when I am the previous lesson, I already prepared the video. If any number is multiplied into 11, how to multiply that? So don't do do this method always. Just you have to learn. If you attend one class means you have to learn one thing, new thing. Don't what we have done in the previous same bootstrap of that method or solving in that same method. That is not use of that. So in this method, in my previous lecture, I explained that if any digit number, not only 2 digit, any digit number multiply with 11. This 11 is must. Here is must, and this may be the changes, either 3 or 4 or 100. We don't bother about that. Now, how to multiply this? And don't multiply like this 3, 2, and into here, 1, again 3 here, again 2 here. After that, addition 3, 5, 2. Yes, I will solve this problem in 1 second. That is, what is that? What is the first number? Write the first number, give the some space. Give some space and write the last digit number, and after that add these two numbers. 2 plus 3 is how much? 5. That's your answer. Did you got that same? Yes. These all the methodologies I explained in the previous lecture only. There are the few videos are there in our YouTube channel. You can go and learn by your own. Okay. And next is, if the numbers are not 11, for example here 12 and here is the 25, for example, like this is the number, then how to solve this problem? And for like this problem also, I explained you that, for example, 12 into 25 is there. Don't do like this the method. This is wrong method in Olympiad. I'm not saying that it's a complete wrong. This is in Olympiad point of view, don't want to use, because of in the Olympiad means what? You have to give the answers in less than seconds. Yes, in seconds you have to calculate that. So if you apply this methodology in the Olympiad, then what is the use of Olympiad and normal mathematics? See, yes or no? So in this method, how I am multiplying? First multiply these two. 2 5s are 10, carry 1, 0 here. In the second step, 2 2s are 4, right here down of the carry, 1 5s are 5, 4 plus 1 5, 5 plus 5, 10. Out of 10, what is the unit place? 0. Again here is a what? 1 is a carry. And last step, 2 1s are 2. Here already carries how much? 1. 2 plus 1, 3. Your answer is this. So to avoid this much of lengthy calculation, you have to use some shortcuts. Not only for the 2 digit into 2 digits, it is also applicable 3 digit into 3 digits. 3 digit into 3 digit. Up to 3 digit into 3 digit, you have to do the problems in this methodology. The remaining problem in your standard model only, I am not telling the 4 by 4, 5 by 5, 6 by 6. Yes, for that problem also there is a what we call that methodology shortcuts are there. But in the 5th standard you learn up to 3 digits how to multiplication. And along with this, you know already your basic fundamental model, that is how to multiply that. Yes or no? Yes. The next is, next division. Yes, everybody knows the division or not? Yes. How to divide that? For example, here number is 20 division by 4. Yes, like this. Then how to do the division? And here sometime we are writing the 4, 20 here, like this. Yes or no? 4 5s are here, you can write. This is the quotient. Sometimes the students may are writing here also. There is no problem for me. 20, you can write anywhere. Yes, this is the solution. And this is the remainder, and this is the quotient, divisor and dividend. Yes or no? So when you are solving the problems in the Olympiad mathematics, your job is don't just avoid this method. You know that how to write in simplest form. Yes or no? Most probably avoid these lengthy methods. In Olympiad mathematics, what to do? Do you know that? Use the simplest methods. For example, here 4 table, 4 ones are. In the same 4 table, where the 20s goes, 5s are. So your answer is 5. That's the answer. Khatam. For example, one more problem. We will see that. Next problem is, for example, 72 is there. Yeah, right here, 72 is there. And here is a divided by 4. Then what to do? Yes, your job is right here, 4 ones are, and here is how much? 4 ones are 4. 7 minus 4 is how much? 3 is left. Now this number become 32. In 4 table, where the 32 is possible? 4 eights are 32. That's the answer. Right? Yes. Now see the next. Here, this is a very important. For solving of the problem, this is the important formula we have to remember. Not remember, there is the operation is this. In that, for example, if you are solving the problem like this, it has what? Divisors and dividend. Yes or no? Divisor. This is called divisor. Yes, this is divisor and this is dividend. This is dividend and this is quotient and this is remainder. Everybody knows that. For example, let's take the small easy problem, that is 25 division by, initially I will explain the problem in the normal fundamental model. Yes, this 5 is a what? Divisor. Yes or no? This 25 is a what? Dividend. In 5 table, where the 25 is goes? 5 5s are, 5 5s are 25, is 0. Yes or no? Yes. Now see that. This is a 5 and this is divisor, this is dividend and this is quotient and remainder. This is what? Remainder. For this, there is a one shortcut formula is there to remember them. How? So your divisor dividend is there, na? That dividend, the 25 will come. How? Multiply of this divisor, that is 5, into this quotient, yes, write in bracket, plus 0. If you multiply these two numbers and add the remainder, you will get dividend. You will get dividend. Here, see that. Are you getting or not? 5 5s are 25 or not? 25 plus 0 is how much? 25 only. So your answer is 25. That is dividend. Yes, in this way also you can learn. Here, see that they gave the formula. Dividend is equal to quotient into divisor plus remainder, and try to bracket it. They not mention the bracket here. Please mention the bracket. So according to the Bodmer's rule, you have to first solve the what brackets. First solve brackets. In the bracket, what is that? Quotient into divisor. You multiply these two and add that to remainder. Add the number to this resultant. But don't first add these two. This is wrong. First you have to do multiplication of these two. And you will get resultant. Add resultant to this remainder. That's the answer. That will give that what? Dividend. Based on this, there are the more number of problems are there. Based on this, more number of problems they will ask you in the competitive exam point of view, in Olympiad exam. Now see, so, and remaining is what? The relations between the additions and subtractions, multiplications and divisions. I will tell you in the next class. Up to that, you have had this formula. Based on this formula, try to solve the more and more problems. Okay? And if you have any doubts, you can post it in the comment box. Up to that, sign off. Bye-bye.